2015, a month after we being released from prison, I was walking around with a camera. I see players like this playing football. I walked to them and said, "What are you guys doing?" I was like, "You don't play for a local team?" They're like, "No." I was like, "I'm going to start a football team." They're like, "Well," I didn't know what the style was. I was wearing bootcut jeans and whatever trainers were. They're all laughing at me like, "You can't start no football team." I was like, "Guys, I'm going to start a football team."
Cool man, false nine. I can play anywhere and I shine. I got more than a lot on the line. To take on a man, get twined. To take on a man, get twined. I got more than a lot on the line. I can play anywhere and I shine. They call man, false nine. They call man, false.
People laugh at me now when I say Peckham Zidane, but he'll tell you I was one of the best players in Peckham. I was one of the best players in Peckham. I should have gone to Jamaica, but circumstances. I remember people just going to do street robberies. They're like, "Oh, nah, I'm not involved in that." Yeah, but everyone will come back with new phones and go and sell them. And it was actually introduced by him. My dream, just as any kid today, was I'm going to be a professional footballer. I had no doubts in my mind I was going to make it. But got caught up with the gangs and crime. When I was 18, I signed for Ilford. They were playing the Ramy Division 1. We were in the reserve team at the time, but scoring lots of goals, lots of goals, lots of goals. And then Ashford Town Middlesex signed me in the Ramy Prem. I was 20 at the time, signing around in Prem, which is equivalent of being like 7th division of British football. The day I was making my debut was the day one of my friends also got murdered. That day was probably the day that changed my whole sort of course, because maybe 4 days later I got arrested. After being released from prison, I said, "You know what? I'm going to start a team in Hackney, create the platform to give these kids a chance. Keep them a distraction from the gang, give them a distraction from just hanging out in the streets and say, you know what, I'm going to go to training." But as much as we're trying to change their mentalities, the gang members are trying to recruit them as well. So it's a constant battle between us trying to recruit them to the football and then the gang members trying to recruit them to carrying drugs and representing blocks. "Where have you been though?" "Yeah? I see the draw of it. I see the draw of the excitement, the adrenaline of belonging to an area. But as God is my witness, I can't count my fingers and toes how many friends I've known who have been murdered, who are dead right now. And I'm one of the lucky ones that made it. My brother's one of the lucky ones that made it. My brother got shot 4 times and he's still alive. So it sort of allows me to keep saying, you know what, keep working, because you're not going to save every single child. But even if I can influence one child, he then can influence another 5 and they can, so then it goes on. We don't sell them dreams. We don't say come to the football club and you become a professional footballer. We say come to the football club, one, give you a bit of education, keep you out of trouble, keep you fit. If we can make you a professional footballer, then that's a bonus, but that's not the goal. It's not just about football. Football is what brings these kids here. Once we've got their attention through football, through providing with a semi-professional football club in the borough, what avenues can we push them into? We're trying to build up the skills and connections and networks to get these people into work, think outside the blocks.
"Let's go, boy, let's start again."
Ernest saying that, they said, "Oh, why don't you get some youth team down?" And Ernest said that it's not in his remit to bring through the youth, but his objective is to win and get promoted. I said, I don't care about promotion. I care about the youth getting in. When I started the football club, I had lots of friends who were coming out of prison and saying, "Oh yeah, I heard you're starting a football club, I want to come and join." Getting some of these guys who were involved in crime before coming out and sort of saying, "You know what, I'm going to concentrate on football." One of my friends, he started coming to play with us as well, but he was still doing what he was doing. I'm not going to turn a blind eye, but when you come to football, you come to play football. What you do in your other life, I can't really control. I think it was our second game of the season. He's meant to be one of our kits. I think he had the number 9 or something. He didn't bring it back. And then we heard that he was on a run because he committed a murder. Things like that sort of thing makes you think, you know what, you need to try harder. Forget just targeting the adults, let's target some of these youths. Let's create youth teams so that we change the mentality from age 6, 7, 8. This is sort of the epicenter of where sort of kids come to try to keep out of trouble. And I've never really seen any incidents happen over here. Look across there, you've got the Kingsmead Estate over there. They don't get along with the guys over there in Homerton, but everyone, when they come over to the pitch, they normally sort of leave all their gang differences behind and just come and play football. No matter who you are, what religion you are, what race, what ethnicity, what sexual orientation, football is a unifier. Going to Hackney Marshes to go and see Bradley. We owe them a bit of money. So he's going to tell us exactly how much we owe them. I think we paid them properly for nearly a year, something like that, I don't know. Hey, how are you, Bradley?
What's the damage, Bradley? What's the damage?
It's gonna be a lot, mate. First and foremost, though, what's going on with your payments?
The stadium we're playing costs about £350 to £400, plus referees. You're looking at £560 every single time we have a home game. We're trying to sort of make sure, okay, do we have enough finance to cover this, we have enough finance to cover that, but at the same time, still give the kids enjoyment of playing football and so on as well. Here's guys, subs. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, guys, it can't be every single week the same thing, I'm sorry. Guys, you have to start learning how to budget. Why are these guys playing again? Why is he playing again? No, you know he didn't pay, you know this. I told you this yesterday, I'm gonna cancel it. Listen, who paid? Who's paying? You owe from last week, that's 30. You owe from last week, 35. You owe from last week, 40. That's £40 that the club don't get. Pitch fees, referees. If they've got issues where they can't pay, I have to tell all them all the time. If there's any point they can't pay, they'll help the club out in what other way, by volunteering. They all know this.
What were you doing at that age then?
17, I think that's when I was really, I was selling drugs. This is the issue I have now. I'm having a go at them, say, guys, you're not paying your subs, you can't come. Like, the club won't run at all if we're not strict. But then the gang member will say, you know what? You know what I mean? Forget about playing Ganja football where you have to pay money. We will actually give you money to come and do these things for us. They're giving them things that most kids want in terms of, oh, expensive trainers, looking good for the girls, and money, cars, so things that we can't give to them physically. So it is difficult.
You're all doing fundraising this weekend.
Now, guys, I'm actually being serious. I'm not joking around. Cause like, that's like £40-£50 the club's not gonna have now, and then you guys are gonna, like, seriously, go in. And then, guys, right? What's up? Hackney Wick in the Premiership. We've got so much momentum, but the one thing that's lacking is the stadium. Yeah. Imagine there's a stadium in Hackney. Every single Saturday, local kids from the local schools, their parents, oh, let's go and watch Hackney Wick. But now people can do that, but oh, let's go for a skate. This is meant to be Hackney Stadium. This is the show pitch in Hackney. It's got a rope around it. So we're trying to say, look, let's create a stadium in Hackney. You could do some form of infrastructure, a turnstile, a stand could just sit even 80, 90 people, doesn't matter, floodlights, and that's about it. Look how much kids are here playing today, but once they get a bit older, there's no adult team to then play for in a borough. Again, so much regulation and red tape around things, so. There's 8 teams playing today. I literally do about 5 miles walking up and down to different teams.
Refs, that was a bit soft, weren't it? Shoulder to shoulder.
So on these pitches they'll have all the under 8s and under 9s playing, and then on the main pitches over there is under 11.
Hey, bang, finish it! Oh, yeah! Well done!
Is that your first ever goal? Tell your mum, innit?
Hackney Wick can come forward here with a lot of numbers. And hashtag are just stepping off them here. 18, the substitute.
Oh my God, what a finish.
Hackney Wick and their bench are going absolutely crazy.
We score and we won. Hackney Wick FC, we score and we won.
People are starting to know about us. We broke the league record last year for the Essex Senior League. And that nearly 800 people turned up to our match versus Clapton FC. So there's atmospheres like that that we want to replicate in Hackney.
Yeah, but we are inspired by what AFC Windmill has done.
They're not even like 15 years old, I think. Yeah. So to even get to League One and do like 2 leagues away from the Premiership, it just shows it is possible, but then you need the financing, you need the structure, you need a stadium and so on. So
it just shows what you can do with grassroots support, from their calling out to their community to saying that, you know, we want to do something together. That really inspired us.
Been broken, although I'm not worthy, you fix me. Now I'm blinded by your grace.
We're enjoying it, right? Like, we ain't got millions, we can't go out and go and buy Ronaldo, we can't even bloody buy Dave from the chip shop. But we're just saying that, you know what, you can be young, you can be black, you can be from a disadvantaged community and still have ownership or something. And that's what we're trying to teach, that you can become owners.